You go into the conclave, and now there's another book. That's the green book there?
Yes, it's green book. And then this book, when I you go into the conclave, and this book's at your place, and it says, these are the prayers we say during the conclave, the whole liturgy. And so it's not just about voting, but it's about praying that God would inspire us to make a proper choice, because after all, we are electing a successor of Peter, the vicar of Christ, and this is God's work. Mm-hmm. And so prayer was very much a part of our deliberations and participation. Every day we began with a Mass, and then when we come together from the place where we celebrated Mass to the conclave, the Sistine Chapel as such, we had this book, and there were prayers that we would say before we began our deliberations, and in the middle, and so forth. And so this is a prayer book in which we invited the Holy Spirit to tell us what to do and how to vote.
You I know you can't explain the deliberation process itself, but certainly just the surroundings. You brought something back here that I think we would all find interesting.
Well, as we walked into the conclave, we walked in and we took the oath.
Took the oath, right?
We took the oath, and then we were all assigned a seat. And we're all assigned a seat according to our seniority, the seniority in which we were made cardinals. And so the cardinal who is the oldest would lead the procession, and then, for example, in the College of Cardinals, those allowed a vote at that last year. There were 117 of us. Two were sick and couldn't come. Mm-hmm. So there were 115 in the conclave. And as we opened, I went to my place, and we all had this beautiful piece and opened it up. And in the folder was a list. First time I've ever seen one like this, of all the cardinals who were under 80 who could vote for the Pope. I said two were not there, and the cardinals are divided into three classes. One are the episcopal cardinals, mm-hmm. and these are the cardinals, here we have five of them, who have churches in and around Rome. They live in proximity to the Holy Father and very much involved, maybe in if he needs things on a daily basis. Mm-hmm. Those are the episcopal cardinals. Then we have the presbyteral cardinals, the priest cardinals. These are cardinals who, like myself, are cardinals in an archdiocese somewhere in the world. And so the bulk of the cardinals are people who are out throughout the world who minister to the people in various geographic areas. And then there are the deacon cardinals. And like a deacon, they are people of service. Mm-hmm. And these are, here there are 17 on the list who work in Rome in the Curia. They're the staff to the Holy Fathers.
So these are numbered by the order in which
these
you were made?
These are numbered by their order, and if you go down this order, one familiar name here is Cardinal Sciacca, and then you go down a little further, and there's my name at number 46. So I was just a little bit above midpoint,
right.
in the College of Cardinals electing the Pope. So I wasn't too old or too young. I was right in the middle, pretty much.
And I have there were 100 of the cardinal priests,
yes.
5 of the cardinal bishops, and 17 of the cardinal deacons, but they all have a vote, just like each other.
That's right.
One vote for each one.
One vote. And what happens, according to the instruction for the conclave, mm-hmm. the person who has been chosen out of lot to oversee mm-hmm. The voting, says it's now time to vote. And so this is like a...
it's like a scorecard.
It's a scorecard, all right. And we call it a vota scrutini. That means the vote of those who are voting. Mm-hmm. And so whenever we began the process for election, according to the instruction, the way it happened. In this folder was also the ballot. And this ballot says, I elect as Supreme Pontiff, and there's a line here, and we each had a pen, and we would just write our name. So on my right, was the Cardinal of Yugoslavia. On my left was Cardinal Gordo from Spain, and I was in the middle, and there's, everything is silent. Mm-hmm. Everybody's in prayer, and we're all asked, no talking among each other, to each other, for each other. We just do this, and then we fold it this in half, and we hold it in our hand. And then according to this list, we then walk to the altar, and we all take an oath that the man whose name appears on our ballot is the man I think would be best suited to be the Pope. So we put it on a plate on the altar, and we take this oath every time we voted.
So the ballots aren't signed. They include the name of the person for whom you're voting.
That's right. This includes, I write it down.
Okay.
And then we put it on the altar, and then every cardinal comes up and does that. So it takes over an hour to go through this process. And then after that process, they take that plate and they put it into another container. It looks like a chalice. And they put all the ballots in. And then there are three, and according to the instruction, there are three cardinals chosen by lot who then count the ballots. And they do it in front of a table like this, and one cardinal will pick it out of that chalice. He'll show it to the second cardinal, and then the third cardinal will announce it.
Mm-hmm.
At that point, we all have our scorecard, so to speak, and he announces it. And so we keep tabs on everybody whose name is spoken, right? And we all hold our breath in the end, hoping there are only 115 and not one more, not one less, nobody voted twice or anything. So we had no problems there. And so that whenever then there is no there's no majority plus one on the first ballot and how many ballots it would take, all of this is collected, and then it's put into the stove, which is brought into the Sistine Chapel. You got a live fire in the Sistine Chapel. And put all these. You're not allowed to keep any notes.
Mm-hmm.
No notes. Any notes you have, you take the oath of silence and not to disclose this anything that happens in that conclave, and it's burned. And after it's burned, then we will have a second ballot.
Right, and of course, the smoke from those right. burning ballots plus these scorecards is what everyone's looking for, because they want to see what color it is to see whether a new pope has been elected.
Right, and we know that sometimes the smoke is not quite black or white.
Right.
People are guessing. But ultimately, we know that whenever there was a majority plus one, the voting always continues till the last vote is counted, and then of course you have the announcement of who is elected.